We're on Sukkah, Perek Gimel, Mishnah Yud Bet, 12th Mishnah, in the third chapter of Masechet Sukkah. Okay, Mishnah says the following. Well, in order to actually, before we get to the Mishnah, we have to look at the Pasuk, which we've used until now, in order to learn about the taking of the Arba Minim. Says the Torah, Ulekachtem lachem bayom harishon, pre-eitz hadar anaf kapot varim v'anaf eitz avot v'arbe nachem. Okay, it says you should take on the first day, pre-eitz hadar, the four species, etro, kapot, marin, devanta, lula, vanasef, vanafisavot, hadasim, arbeinacham, usmachtem lifnei Hashem elokechem shivat yamim. And you should rejoice before Hashem your God 7 days. So, which is it? On the one hand, we have Bayom HaRishon, the first day. But then it says shivat yamim. So, the Mishnah says that to solve this problem, the Chazal understood the Pasuk in a very interesting way. Barishona, originally, hayalulav nital bamigdash shiva. Ubamdina yom echad. Okay, because the lulav was taken in the Beit Hamikdash for 7 days, all 7 days. Ubamdina, and Medina is anywhere outside of the Beit Hamikdash, according to the Rambam, derech agav, anywhere outside of Yerushalayim. Medina, Bartanura says, is Yerushalayim. It's called Gigvulin, it's outside. But the Rambam says Yerushalayim itself, all of Yerushalayim, is considered the Mikdash for the purposes of Netilat Lulav, which means that if someone who lives outside of Yerushalayim and comes to Yerushalayim, without a doubt, should shake the lulav. Because according to the Rambam, he's Mekayim Mitzvah De'oraita. I forgot to do that when we went to Yerushalayim this year. I got to fix that. Oh, anyway, but that's how they learn the Pasuk. Ulekachtem lechem b'yom harishon, anywhere. But, smachtem lifnei Hashem elokechem shivat yamim, 7 days, if you're in the Beit HaMikdash. But, mishachara Beit HaMikdash, when the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, hitkin Rabban Yochanan ben Zakkai shei lulav nital b'medina shiva. Zechel HaMikdash. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai decreed, he instituted, that we should shake the lulav all 7 days in the Medina, Zechel HaMikdash, as a remembrance of the Beit HaMikdash. Okay, so therefore, we learn that according to the Torah, the first day Yom Echad is Deoraita, and then the rest of the days that we fulfill the Nitilat Lulav, it's only a Din de Rabbanan, Zechel HaMikdash. Mishnah continues. In addition, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai also decreed, Shiyeh Yom HaNef Kulo Asor. Yom HaNef is the day of the waving. So let's just translate and I'll have to explain. He explained, Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said that the day of the waving should be totally asur, it's prohibited on the whole day. What's this talking about? This is talking about Hanafat HaOmer. Let's go to, this is Vayikra Perek Kaf Gimel. Okay, Vayikra Perek Kaf Gimel talks about the idea of the bringing of the Omer on the second day of Pesach. Okay, we have to read the Psukim. Shem said, Dabel b'nei Yisrael v'yamarta aleihem, speak to the children of Israel and say to them, Ki tavo el ha'aretz asher ani noten lechem u'ktzartem k'tzira, v'aveitem et omer reshit k'tzircha mela kohen. Okay, when you come to the land, you cut your cuttings, you reap the harvest, you should bring the omer, the beginning of your cuttings, to the kohen. V'heinif et ha'omer lifnei Hashem. They should wave the omer. Let's just show this word. Heinif, remember we saw this word? Let's go back to our Mishnah. Yom ha'nef, that's the same word. Okay, let's go back to the pasuk. Oops, wrong pasuk. Here we go. Ve'nifet ha'omer lifnei Hashem mitzonchem. Mimacharat ha'shabbat yinifenu ha'kohen. Mimacharat ha'shabbat, on the morrow after the Sabbath. Chazal learned out, very famously, that this refers to the day after Pesach, the first day of Pesach. The second day of Pesach, yinifenu ha'kohen. That's Yom Hanef. And what's the halacha? I'm going to skip the korbanot. Ve'lechem v'kali v'karmel lo tochlu ad etzem ha'yom hazeh ad aviyachem et korban Elohechem. Okay, you may not eat bread or parched corn or fresh ears at etzem hayom hazeh. This is a din called chadash. New grain that grew in the past year from Pesach may not be eaten ad aviyachem et korban alochem until you bring the korban haomer. Chukat olam ledorotechem b'chom hashvotechem. This is the din called chadash. Chadash is a din de'oraita. New grain cannot be eaten until the waving at etzem hayom hazeh, until that day ad aviyachem et korban alochem, until you bring the offering. So Chazal said, whoa, 1 second, let's read the Pasuk. Ad etzem hayom hazeh means until the day. But then it says, Ad aviyachem et korban alochem, until they bring the korban. So when is it? Am I allowed to eat chadash on etzem hayom hazeh, on the second day before? Let's say at 8 o'clock in the morning, can I have a bagel fresh from chadash? Or do I have to wait, Ad aviyachem et korban alochem, until I bring the korban? So let's look at the Bar Tanura here. Bar Tanura says, okay, one Pasuk it says, Ad aviyachem. The Bizman Beit HaMikdash Kayam. The Beit HaMikdash was in existence. Misha karav ha'omer, when they brought the omer, hayu ochlim chadash bo bayom, they would eat chadash. Yichtiv ad haviyachem. until you bring the korban. Umisha kishachara Beit Hamikdash. But when the Beit Hamikdash are destroyed, mutar minatara mishiira mizrach. As soon as the sun came up in the east. Why? Because it says, ad etzem hayom hazeh. Until the one day. Okay, so that's how they learned it. Meaning when there's a Beit Hamikdash, then it's ad haviyachem, until you bring the pasuk, until you bring the korban. But if there's no Beit Hamikdash, then it's ad etzem hayom hazeh, until the beginning of the day. It's very interesting to think Chazal understood the pasuk to refer to when there wouldn't be a Beit Hamikdash. That's another issue entirely. But Rabbi Yochanan, so when there was no Beit Hamikdash, and that was the time of Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai, there was no Beit Hamikdash. So Rabbi Yochanan, so in his time, theoretically, at 8 o'clock in the morning or 9 o'clock in the morning, they were allowed to eat their fresh chadash bagels. But this is what Asar Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai aleim kol yom. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai said, no, we're going to say the whole day is Asar. Even though Bidin Torah, you can eat from the morning, we're going to do the whole day. Why? Because one day soon, quickly, the build-up Beit Hamikdash will be rebuilt. And they'll say, Ishtakad milo havi achlinen mishiira mizrachli. Last year we ate at 8 o'clock in the morning. So this year, hashtana minechal, this year we can also eat at 8 o'clock in the morning. And they're not going to realize that the halacha changed, because last year there was no Beit Hamikdash. And this year there is a Beit Hamikdash, so you have to wait until they bring the korban. So therefore, let's read back the Mishnah. Rabbi Yochanan ben Zakkai decreed, Shiehe yom hanef kulo, that the whole day of the waving of the korban omer, i.e. the second day of Pesach, was kulo asur. The whole day they didn't eat chadash. And the reason I always loved this Mishnah was, because what was Rabbi Yochanan's fear? His fear was, next year the Beit Hamikdash is going to be built and they're not going to remember. Remember last year we had chadash. First of all, everyone's going to remember chadash. Halavai, the people would be, you know, aware in Israel we're makbir on chadash. In America, they're not. It's one of my big pet peeves. I don't know why the OU or doesn't have a chadash division. It doesn't make any sense to me. But even more so, he's like, Beit Hamikdash is going to be built, and it's going to happen soon. And then they're not going to remember from year to year. He made a halacha. The beauty of this halacha is that it was an established halacha because the Beit Hamikdash is going to be built. And we don't want mistakes to happen from last year to this year. It shows his connection and his faith and his desire, on the one hand, in the past. Should people have Zeichel HaMikdash? Should remember the lulav of Zeichel HaMikdash? And also halachot of Zeichel HaMikdash for the future. That the Beit Hamikdash is not something that was just in the past, but we have to prepare for it and be ready so we won't make mistakes when the Beit Hamikdash is rebuilt. It's a beautiful idea. I've always found it very beautiful. We'll stop here and dedicate a little to the memory of my father. Comments or questions at arsplotter@gmail.com. Have a great day.